You're always the most beautiful woman in the room.
I like the hat.
Would you like to come visit me this Sunday?
Yes, yes, I would.
You went away with her, right? What happened?
You're in a trance.
I'm wide awake. I've never been more awake in my life. Why don't you leave me alone?
Carol is set in the early 1950s, and it follows the unexpected love affair between two women of different ages and different social settings.
What a strange girl you are.
Why?
Flung out of space.
I'd worked with Cate in my Bob Dylan-inspired film, I'm Not There, and she famously transformed into the electric Dylan in a shape-shifting performance that still astounds me.
Who cares what I think? I'm not the president. I'm not some shepherd. I'm just a storyteller, man. That's all I am.
Well, so I was so excited to work with Cate again and to see how she could pull it off as a woman this time.
What are you thinking? Do you know how many times a day I ask you that?
Sorry. What am I thinking? I'm thinking that I'm utterly selfish and I should...
Don't do this. You had no idea. How could you have known?
And I should have said no to you, but I never say no. And it's selfish because... because I just take everything and I don't know anything and I don't know what I want. How could I when all I ever do is say yes to everything?
Rooney's fantastic. She's just not fazed by anything. Really even, you know, in terms of her temperament on set, but then where she can go, you know, emotionally and physically and psychologically, it's sort of that it really belies that ability.
Come to France. Let's get married.
Richard, yeah. I'm not ready for that. I can't just make myself.
What? Tell me.
Sorry, I have to go.
Terry!
Rooney is just an impeccable talent. I feel like she understands the medium of film. And for somebody this age to know how to calibrate the scale of articulation for this intimate medium, I think it speaks to extraordinary intelligence and innate ability.
Why do you hate me? I haven't done anything to you.
You really think I've flown halfway across the country to drive you back east because I hate you and want to see you suffer?
I play Abby, who is a former lover of Kate's character, Carol, and who then, when she cannot have Cate in a romantic way anymore, she chooses to stay in her life to be her confidant and her best friend.
Sarah Paulson brings a profound, poignant understanding, I think, of this history to the character, and you see it in that face.
I'm closing the door.
I love her.
I can't help you with that.
Kyle Chandler, who is such a gifted actor, such a real powerhouse of an actor, I think, brings a sort of unexpected level of sympathy to what could very easily be an unsympathetic character. And so it's balanced by this person who's both vulnerable for the first time to the woman in his life, but also angry.
What are you gonna do? What are you gonna do? Are you gonna stay here with Abby over Christmas? You gonna stay with the shop girl in there? Huh? What are you gonna do, Carol, huh? What is the plan?
Stop it!
Damn it! I'd put nothing past women like you, Carol.
You married a woman like me. You know, he's a modern man, but he looks so... he's such a man. You know, not a lot of men in cinema, but he's a man. And had one with such heart and is not so full of ego that he can't be broken or fragile or full of shame.
And action!
Oh, okay, so it's kind of just where I pass.
Exactly.
Todd is the most exquisite conductor. He assembles a group of people and makes sure that everyone's on the same page. He invites the actors, the crew, everyone into the visual world. Everyone on set feels empowered and valued and a participant.
Sounds good. Okay.
Everything comes full circle. We gave each other the most breathtaking of gifts.
Did you know that Pumbaa in The Lion King was the first character
to fart in a Disney movie? For this and more movie facts, click on more videos.